Casio A500 WGA. Let's take a look at this. I actually received this watch as a mistake, a seller mistake. I originally ordered a A500WA1, which is silver, chrome actually, and I open the box and I get this, the gold version, which I have seen sell for as high as $50. I'll have it linked so you can check it out for yourself, but wow. Nice. Okay, so I got the gold version. I almost sent it back because it is borderline tacky, but I didn't because it's got a clean look. So, yeah, I've decided to hang on to it. Now, this one, and I'll show this right now. Actually, let me put this over here. This is an AE1200, and why am I showing this? Because the feature set between this and this, identical. The only thing about this which is different, aside from the way it looks, aside from the fact it has a nylon band and plastic all around instead of a metal stainless steel band, is that this has a fundamental feature difference. This has a 10-year battery. This does not. This has 100 meter water resistance. This just has water resist, which basically means splash resistance. Shower with this one, can't shower with this one. Go swimming with this one, yes, can't go swimming with this one. That's basically the difference between those two. This is meant to be used as a dress watch. So anyway, let's go through some features of this. Okay, this is pretty much designed as a traveler's watch. Actually, you know what, before I do that, let's talk about this right here. Okay, because this confuses people somewhat. This is what's known as the Casio adjustable clasp. There are no links to add or remove anywhere on this band, and the reason for that is that this thing slides back and forth. How do we get it to do that? You would take something like this. This is a slotted screwdriver. You put it, let me see if I can get this right in here. Now, I'm not going to do it on camera, but you take it and you flip that up. Actually, you know what? I will do it. You take it like this and see how that comes up. And then at this point, it's loose and I can move it back and forth. And then when you find the desired position you want, you just snap it back down. That is how you adjust this clasp. Any Casio that has this, that is how you do it. All the other ones use links that you have to add and remove. So anyway, this is my absolute favorite way to adjust a band on or anything that has stainless steel. It's brilliant the way it works. Okay, so what we have on the face here is we have three individual displays up here. We have the map. Then we have the main timekeeping part of it, which is weekday, month, day, hour, minute, second. Over at this area, it would show whether it's post-meridian or not, which is PM. So to get everything on this side lit up, so to speak, all right, alarm is on. So if I go to alarm and I turn it off. Actually, I have another alarm. Yep. If there's any alarm, there's five alarms in this, which I'll get to in a second. If there's any alarm on, ALM will show at the top. So I'll turn this one off. Okay, now as you see, there's nothing there. So if I go back to the original alarm here and I turn that on, see how ALM came on? If I turn it off, it goes out. Okay, so that's on. I'll explain what one on means in a moment. Now, as far as the next part, SIG. Okay, what SIG means, and let me just, actually not SIG, mute. You can mute the button beeps in this watch on the main timekeeping screen by pressing and holding, mode. So if I press and hold this, there it is. See how mute is at the top left? Will it focus? Well, you can see that. So now it's mute. So if I press the button now, you don't hear anything. The alarm will still sound, whether it's a countdown timer or alarm, but regular function beeps, no. It will be muted. Now, the last one is SIG. That is done on alarm. After your 5 alarms, you have this one, which is 00. This is hourly chime. So if I turn this on, see how it says SIG? Okay, now all 3 of them are on there. You have mute, alarm, SIG. Mute means that the function button presses are muted. Alarm means there is at least one alarm enabled, one or more. And SIG means that there will be an hourly chiming, a beep beep, every hour. That's what that means. So we'll turn that off, go back to the home screen, press and hold mode to turn mute off. There we go. And go to alarm, and we will turn the alarm off. And now all 3 are out. Okay. Now that's out of the way. Setting the alarm, setting the time. We do that from adjust and hold. Okay, so we start with seconds and we scroll through these with the mode button. You turn daylight, DST means daylight saving time, on or off. You set your time zone here using up or back. You have hour, minute, and then this is where you set 12 hour or 24 hour. And yeah, it's kind of a buried function that they put 12 or 24 so deep within the setting here, but that is how you get to it. And then you set the year. I believe this is configurable up to year 2099. And then the month, and then the day. And then LT means light. You can have it as 1 second or 3 seconds. I have mine set to 1 second to save on battery life. But that's what LT means. It means on any screen, if you hit this button for light, it will either show for 1 second or show for 3 seconds. So like I said, I have it set for 1. And that's it. And then you press adjust again to leave that. Now, as far as... another thing you can do on this screen is that you can scroll through your time zones that you have configured here. To adjust a time zone, you press this first, this, and adjust and hold second. Now I am adjusting the time zone for time zone setting 2. And that is the way that I do that. When I'm done, I press adjust again. There's one more thing I think I can do here. No, it's not this one. Oh, I got to remember how to do this. Because I have one of my time zones set with DST enabled. You can do that with this. Okay, let's go try it. Is it this one? No, it's not the light screen. Oh, there it is. Okay. I'll do that again just to show you. Okay, when adjusting a time zone, you you scroll through your zones with these two, and then you press mode, and you can have DST on or off on a per time zone basis. That's how you do that. Okay, and finally, on this screen, if you press and hold search until it beeps, it will go through each of the time zones every 2 seconds. That's how that works. And if I press and hold it again, yeah, I don't even think I have to press and hold, just press and it will stop. On the next screen, I have mine set to UTC, but this is a 5th time zone you can have configured. So you can adjust it with this, I think. Was I thought so? Oh no, you said it with this, I'm sorry. Yeah, this is how you set it. This one you cannot scroll forward or back for some reason. The other ones you can, but this one you can't. So I'm going back here to... And you'll notice the map changes as I continue along here. I'm going back to UTC. There we go. So you do have the ability to do 5 time zones. So you have 4 on the last screen and you get the 5th one here, which is cool. It's not redundant, just a little weird in the way it's configured that I can't scroll forward or back. I can just on the fly, you know, go, but the adjust button doesn't do anything on the screen for whatever reason. But anyway, next screen. Okay, alarms. As you saw from a previous, you got five. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If there is in the hourly chime, which I showed you before, if any alarm is on, you know that from seeing ALM at the top here, at least one, it means one or more alarms is enabled. Now the difference between one on and on is this. If it's one on, that means sound one time, then turn off. If it's set to on, that means at 5 p.m. every day, sound. So it means a repeat. So one means don't, it means one instance, and on means repeat. So I have that set to one on. That's what that means. Going through, the, every alarm is the same as far as how it's set up. You just hold adjust and set it. You cannot set this to sound on a specific date, which is kind of a limitation of this, but eh, that's okay. And next one here is a timer, which you change by holding adjust. And you have hour, minute, and second. Now, if I have this set, you can go forward and back, which is nice. If I have this set to zero, the maximum amount of time that this can count down from, as you will see right now, is 24 hours. The other nice part about this is that I can actually set a timer as even as little as 1 second long. And that's what the timer sounds like. Will the timer still run when you are on a different screen? Yes, it will. So if I set this to 10 seconds and begin, then back to the home screen, and I wait about 10 seconds, you'll hear it sound in a moment. There we go. That's the way it works. Set that back to where I had it. Oops, go to that screen. And stopwatch, like any stopwatch you've ever seen, start, you have the ability to split, do lap, whatever. Not really much to show off besides that. And that is it. So, there be gold in them thar hills. On the final note, okay, this material, stainless steel, gold on the front, not gold on the other side. Is it real gold? Of course not. This is it's a fake gold. Is the case metal or not? I'm honestly not sure. This is what I am sure of is that this is a plating. What kind of plating is it? I don't know. I honestly do not know. Will this prove to be durable? No idea. Now, compared to like this one I showed earlier, I know this watch can take a serious beating. And it also has, you know, a 10-year battery, because the battery is bigger in this one compared to this one. This is a CR2025. I think that's a 20... Actually, you know what? I think it'll say it on the back. Does it say it on the back? No, it doesn't. I can look it up easily, though, what the Amazon link will actually state what battery it takes. This one, I'm 99% sure it's a 2025. You'll notice it is also significantly thicker. This one, well, I know that this watch is a 10 millimeter. This is a 10 millimeter thickness. This looks to be about, not much thicker, but something like a 12 or a 13, possibly a 14. It's part of the reason you wear one of these is because if you wear long sleeve shirts, such as I do, this slides under the cuff a lot easier compared to this. So when you're wearing t-shirts or a short sleeve, this is fine. But wearing long sleeve, you need something with a lower profile, and this is it. So links will be in the description if you want to check it out. Worth the money if you were to spend $50 on this? Well, for some it is, because it is, as far as a gold digital watch, this is about as classy as it gets. I had seen none classier. And price point, I don't know if it's worth $50, but there are some out there. You'll see some for like in the 40s or something like that. Just look around. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Take it easy.